So, hello, fellow Toastmasters and guests. A very good afternoon to everyone. Welcome to the medley war of words fight. I am Abhimanyu, and I am the sergeant at arms for today's meeting. The mission of Toastmasters Club is to provide a mutually supportive and positive learning environment in which every member gets an opportunity to improve communication and leadership skills, which in turn boosts self-confidence and personal growth. In every Toastmasters meeting, we follow three or four ground rules. First, please remain muted unless you are asked to or else you have a role. Second, please avoid taboo topics such as sex, religion, and politics. Three, please do join the meeting in a formal attire. And fourth and last, since it's an online meeting, kindly turn off the video when moving. And with this, I want to proceed over the meeting to the president of the Medley Toastmasters Club for today, which is Thomas Abraham. A nice introduction about him. He calls himself a communicator for life. Apparently, through effective communication, he got his needs from day one of his life. Later, he specialized in 360-degree corporate communication and earned a living out of it. Toastmasters is one more avenue to pursue communication in its many forms, which he counts it as one of his greatest joy. With this, I will hand over to President of the day, Thomas Abraham. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Abhimanyu. Good afternoon, Toastmasters and all future Toastmasters. My pleasure to welcome all of you to Medley's WW5, War of Words number 5. Obviously, this is a series of an annual debate that we've been having, but today's is the first ever debate we're going to have with an outside club. So far, we were fighting within. We now have the muscles to, give some punches outside, we thought. Frankly speaking, Toastmasters stand to gain a lot from this practice of debating. You know, the use of logic, quick wit, sharp mind, repartee. I mean, every way these are strengths we can use well. And as for the audience, if 100 meters dash is exciting, imagine how much more is a 4 into 100 meters dash. It's spectacular. And in fact, in material terms, the time taken is even less per second, per distance, that is. And in current times, I would believe, at a time when open minds are becoming an extinct species, and when people find it much easier to lease out their minds, because you don't have to think, debating has to make a comeback. Debating was always in the middle of all civilizations, citadels of civilization. Starting differently from the Greek civilization, had this tradition. I think it's time Chennai gets this tradition back too. Debate, very primarily speaking, allows us to speak our mind without getting hurt. It gives us the openness to listen to the other side. It becomes a joint search for truth in a pure sense. So this openness to hear other viewpoints broadens the mind and should improve the quality of life. So in that sense, debate is something we are very happy to promote, which we will in a continual way. I must thank DXE, Mr. Kumaravel, with whom I collaborated on this, for allowing this joint debate. And without any further ado, I must pass you on to the debate master. Well heard, well seen in Medley, and now to the outside world too, as a television journalist who essentially covers with great joy defense, space technology, politics, and crime. And not yet Toastmasters, I understand. I'm sure he will increase his repertoire soon. He works as a correspondent with the first ever channel to be banned by China, called Weon. To take us through this wonderful day, over to you, Toastmaster. Sir. Over to you, sir, Toastmaster Siddharth.
Thank you very much, Thomas Abraham, sir, for giving me this opportunity. And greetings to Medley Toastmasters and DXC Toastmasters Club. So we had the professor here explain about debate and the culture of debate ranging back to several civilizations and how its history can be traced back throughout world history. But I think simply put, for all of us commoners, for all of us normal Indians, let's, you know, take a shorter perspective or a shortcut to understand what debate is and where this tradition came about into India's masses. And I fairly think that this is how debate came into being in our country, at least. So here on your screens, you can see how it came to being in our country, at least at the fair stage. And this was at least during the good old days, about 10 years ago, almost a decade ago, when this man was with Times Now. At that point in time, debate only meant two or three people on the screen. But of course, in 10 years, just as journalism has changed, just as the media has changed, debating has undergone a sea change. Well, sea change, you may ask. Well, here sea change is for you. In the next one, you'll see that debating itself has undergone a huge paradigm shift. So 20 years ago, when people envisioned, particularly the scientists at Dolby envisioned surround sound, they seriously did not expect this. They did not factor in this kind of surround sound. We all knew 5.1 and 7.1, but nobody knew 20.1. So this was the pick from the exit poll. So on the exit poll day, Arnab ran a debate with about 20 panelists. So the joke was that Arnab had more seats in the studio than the opposition had in parliament. Well, with no further ado, I'd like to just tell you about the debate we're having today and the intentions behind having this kind of a debate. The purpose of having this very debate is so that we can sharpen our Toastmaster skills and take it to the next level beyond what is in the domain of the books or the manuals that we follow. Moreover, we believe that in Toastmasters, an open forum such as ours, we have the freedom to discuss and debate about several topics. But why not literally take it to not just discuss, but also to debate and try and speak about a topic that is dear to us all at this initial stage. And later on, as we progress, we can also up the level of the topics so that the complexity of the debate and also the interest in the debate increases with time. So now to talk about today's debate, this was something that was pre-planned and based on a toss kind of, we had chosen the topics. So the topic that we had, the proposition that we had was about applying Toastmasters knowledge at home. So here goes. So based on toss, it happens to be this way that Medley won the toss and Medley had to choose and Medley chose it is good to apply Toastmasters knowledge at home. So essentially speaking, plainly, Medley speaks for the motion or for the topic and DXC by default would have to speak against the topic and say it is not good to apply Toastmasters knowledge at home. So well, to talk about the rules that we have for this debate and to talk about the timing guidelines that we have, I'd like to hand over control to our timer for the day. Timer Mohana Sundaram, please.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Fellow Toastmasters and respected idioms, good afternoon. As a timer, I will time the tabletop speakers and the debate speakers. I will also alert the each speaker of the time they have left using a green, yellow, and a red cards, which do not specific timings. For the tabletop speakers, should limit their remarks to no more than 2 minutes. At 1 minute, I will raise a green card. At 1 minute, 30 seconds, I will raise a yellow card. At 2 minutes, I will raise a red card. For the debate speakers, I will raise 3 minutes at the green card. At 3 minutes, 45 seconds, at amber card, 4 minutes, 30 seconds, I will raise a red card. 30 seconds will be awarded for to finish up the speech. And also, I will request a speaker from the each group to sum up their speeches. At 2 minutes, 30 seconds, I will raise a green card. 3 minutes, amber card, and 3 minutes, 30 seconds, red cards. And I will also play the buzzer to indicate the timings for to TMOD.
Thank you, timer. So now we have a 3-on-3 debate. Essentially, we have three people for the topic and three people speaking against the topic. And how it will work is first the speaker going for the motion speaks, and thereafter we have a speaker speaking against the motion, and the sequence goes on. And at the end of it, we have two speakers, a chosen person from each one of these teams, summing up their entire version. And during the sum up, it's important to note that they will not raise any new points, but reinforce their existing points and put forth their conclusion. And also one thing that I'd like to add pertaining to the timing is that during the course of the debate, every debater is not required to use any more than 5 minutes per head. So if you do cross 5 minutes, it is recommended and suggested that you only complete the sentence and leave it at that. Of course, it might be an abrupt ending to your entire motion, but please stop there and don't take any more. And this is in the interest of time and for the smooth conduct of the meeting. And now we can have a look at the three speakers that we have from Medley Toastmasters Club. So on Medley's side, we have Toastmaster Vijay Rajan, who runs a startup on a VR and AR tech. He's a mentor of change at an Atal Thinking Lab. He teaches Silambattam to students on weekends. And then we have Ramesh Murugan, Toastmaster Ramesh Murugan, a chemical engineer associated with Honeywell. And he works as an offering manager. He wished to be the catalyst who helps people improve their happiness index. And finally, we have DTM Sunil Jose, an intellectual property lawyer, and he runs his own legal firm, Suns Legal, past president of Medley and past area director and whatnot. So this goes on to show that Medley spent considerable money on bringing in a lawyer and also somebody who works for a weapons manufacturing firm. For perspective, Honeywell not only makes very sophisticated gadgets, but they also make half of the weapons and the bulletproof vests that are worn by American soldiers. Honeywell is the inventor of the Kevlar bulletproof vest that American soldiers wear. So now, next up we have DXC Toastmasters Club, and leading the pack is DTM Gayatri. So when I asked her for her introduction, she gladly sent me one huge document and said, pick whatever you like. I'm like, are you sort of providing me some kind of a buffet? But gladly I agreed and I picked the first couple of lines for brevity's sake. Software engineer by profession and public speaker by passion, DTM Gayatri is a project manager at DXC. She's pursuing her PG in AI and machine learning right now. Next up, we have another DTM, DTM Sriram Venkat Raman, the testing services lead working in DXC. He likes cricket and he's been a Toastmaster for 6 years for now. And last but not the least, we have Toastmaster Balakrishnan Sundar Rajan, a solution architect at DXC, and he's been a Toastmaster for 3 years. He is, of course, a Big B devotee. He loves watching Hindi movies and blogging. I'm terribly sorry to be the carrier of bad news, but as you would have noticed, the entire family now has tested positive. They're in the Leelavati Hospital in Mumbai, but we do wish them a speedy recovery. Well, that's the six debaters that we have. And at the end of the debate, each chosen person from the particular team will come out and sum up their particular debate and sum up their motion so that they can leave it to the audience who are gathered here to decide which team did the best. So we have the scope for one best debating team, and of course, one best debater. So we have two votes, particularly for the debating segment of our meeting. One just for the best team and the other for the best speaker or the best debater. Just two, there are no runner-ups in this one. I think it's time we begin our debate and we have all of us in the screen. I can see all the debaters, all the participants. So I believe it's time we start the Medley war of words, and the first speaker would be from Medley. And I'd like to call upon Toastmaster Vijay Rajan to kick this off. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, debate master. I'm happy to move the proposition. It is good to apply Toastmaster knowledge at home, because it's just a validation of what you and me as a Toastmaster is doing. Toastmaster gain immensely, not just how to speak, but also how to live happily and successfully. This proposition simply states that many Toastmasters have said that Toastmasters has made a difference in their behavior at home. With Toastmasters, you can develop your communication skill, leadership skill, time management, planning, active listening, integrity, appreciation, and whatnot, which can be applied at home. Good afternoon, Toastmasters. House is made of brick and mortar. Home is made by the people who live there. Your home will become home sweet home if you apply Toastmaster knowledge. Though there are many traits in Toastmasters, I would like to touch upon two areas: listening and voice modulation. Active listening is the crucial part of successful communication. Every Toastmaster meeting provides ample opportunity for everyone to actively listen. Be a listener at home, you will be a great success. Before joining Toastmasters, I used to teach my son his lessons. And whenever he said he is not able to understand, I never actively listened to him. And when I saw his report card, I was shocked to see his low marks. And then after joining Toastmasters, I decided to actively listen and teach him. In the next term, he got good marks. My wife claims her teaching did it. I didn't argue. I listened. And when this lockdown was announced, most of us were thinking how to spend our days at home. But I was worried, how am I going to manage my wife and my mom? That's when my Toastmasters knowledge helped me. I have applied what I have learned when I was preparing for my CC6 speech, voice modulation, which helped me to reduce the anger of my wife during argument. One day, my wife was shouting at me like, "You are responsible for all this mess." I just turned to her and gave a long pause. And then in a lower voice, I said, "Honey, can we have a coffee?" This made me to win the argument. To summarize, Toastmasters is a workshop of ideas where you can develop your long-term vision and your own philosophy of life and methods, and everything will be happiness, peace, and bliss. Now I am eager to hear from the opponent team on why they are not applying these precious traits of Toastmasters at home, despite having spent their valuable time and money for years together in Toastmasters. Thank you. Over to our debate master.
Thank you. Now I hand over control to the first speaker from DXC Toastmasters Club, that is DTM Gayatri. Floor is all yours.
Good afternoon, sir, my dear fellow Toastmasters. If applying Toastmasters knowledge at home would have resulted in better family bonding or family building, we would have enrolled all our spouses, moms, dads, extended family, extended to extended family also. After all, we are all looking for a happy family, aren't we? Out of almost 1,000+ Toastmasters in our own district, we have a handful of them who have the courage to even bring their family members into Toastmasters. Now, if you try to apply the principles of Toastmasters at home, let me assure you it's going to be a recipe for disaster. And my dear Vijayarajan, you talked about how you listen to your son, but family works on the principle of unlistening. If you listen to everything that your wife says and your mother says, I'm very sure you cannot survive with both of them together. You also talked about voice modulation, and you were very smart enough to say how you just asked her for a coffee. Did you have the courage to express the voice modulation when you were angry at her, when you were frustrated about things that were going on? Let me tell you, please don't apply that knowledge, because definitely it's going to be a recipe for disaster. Let us take the principles of Toastmastering as a whole. Toastmaster works on the principles of respect, integrity, service, and excellence. A home is a home only because it works on the principle of love, care, and affection. If there is an unethical act, if somebody does that is not acceptable to the standards of Toastmasters, we disqualify them. But we don't disqualify our family members. We accept them for what they are. We do support them and help them overcome their challenges. But immaterial of their success or failure, we don't disqualify or keep them out of our family, because family is built on the basis of love, care. Toastmaster teaches us to be highly professional people. It asks us to be very sensitive to very small deviations also. And we are very proud when the meeting starts at 2:55 p.m. at Medley, at 12 p.m. at DXC. We want to stick to the timing. Try doing that at any place at your house. I'm very sure it is not even close to reality that you can imagine. When I was a division director, I ensured that my division conference started exactly on time. I didn't even care if the trio were really present there, the district trio, okay? But then on the same year, when I had to run my housewarming, I had to wait for my mother-in-law's brother's family to arrive even before we lit the lamp. because family is built on sentiments and we don't want to hurt people even though you think it is not right for somebody to be delayed for an important occasion. Again, family works on principles that cannot be documented and strictly implemented. I hope you all realize that and ensure that you don't ask your events to be started immaterial of having important people there. Toastmasters, a very important lesson that I learned when I was a division director was how I was impacting my daughter as a mom. I was too proud. I carried her along in any and every event possible. I even took her all to the stage and made her receive an award on my behalf. I was super happy to see the pride gleaming on her eyes. I'm sure she was very happy. In the next 1 year, when I stepped down from the district officer role, I didn't have much to do, so I spent a lot of time doing silly things, playing picnic, and things that didn't even matter much to us. But then I knew that she said more times of I love you in those two moments, because our family doesn't expect us to be great leaders or great communicators. Of course, it's something that they will feel proud of. But then our family requires love, care, affection, and being what we are to them. So be a dad, be a mom, be a son, be a daughter, a family, immaterial of what you are as a division officer, a district officer, or even a distinguished Toastmaster, because a Toastmaster knowledge is supposed to help us grow professionally, while family doesn't work on professional values. It works on personal values of love, care, and affection. Over to the debate master.
Thank you, DTM Gayatri. So next up from Medley, we have the second debater. And this, again, to remind everybody here present in the debate, would be in favor of it is good to apply Toastmasters knowledge at home. And from Medley, we have Toastmaster Ramesh Murugan.
Thank you. Good afternoon, debate master, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests. Let's appreciate DTM Gayatri for trying her best for the wrong side of the argument. I'd like to quote what Mother Teresa said. There is more hunger for love and appreciation in this world than for bread. In Toastmasters, we appreciate all contributions and efforts of our members and guests by giving each speaker a round of applause. This helps energize speakers and it is a great encouragement. So, showing appreciation at home is so important for strengthening relationships. In those days, when I was a kid, getting appreciation from my dad is not so easy. After my exposure to Toastmaster, I, as a parent, see a great value in showing appreciation and started to show appreciation for my kids. We started parenting our kids to show appreciation in simple ways. I'd like to bring to your knowledge that there is a Toastmasters club for underrating. We have Medley Gable Toastmasters Club, which will be an eye-opener for the upcoming generation to learn the Toastmaster skills. We have DTM Sunil, DTM Satish Kumar, who are the backbone for the Medley Gable Club. You all agree that every Toastmasters member knows that the knowledge gained from Toastmasters helps in all walks of life. It is very surprising to hear from DTM Gayatri's speech. She is the project manager and she gave a couple of points. Why not we pull all the members from the family members? It's very simple, ma'am. The project management principles, knowledge sharing. What is the dollar value? We represent one member for the Toastmasters family and they learn the knowledge and then they give the knowledge sharing to the whole family. Need not have to enroll all the members in the Toastmasters. That's number one. Number two, you talked about the time management. It never worked in a home you mentioned. How come you do have a school going children? How do you ensure that the right time they go to the school, is it not come under the time management? In current scenario, what I see is we would be knowingly or unknowingly using Toastmasters principles or knowledge at home. It is something like this. Asymptomatic. Irukku ana theriyadu means it is there but not known. Another important knowledge from Toastmasters, we all might appreciate that we make feel everyone important, regardless of age, gender, nationalities. Toastmasters is all about teaching democratic leadership. At home, it would be good to involve family members in the decision-making and respect individuals' views. Recently, I was planning to buy a few gadgets, like accessories, like desk, monitor, speakers, to set up everything for my two sons and for myself, online connectivity at home. I involved my family members for the model selection, and we decided. It was full of fun. You believe me, it's full of fun, engaging all the members. To support and motivate me today also, my family is watching my speech. I'd like to turn the camera on and then show them actually. So I would like to conclude my speech by referring Brian Tracy's thought on success recipe. Madam DTM Toastmasters, Gayatri mentioned that success recipe would not work. I will re-emphasize. If you go into the kitchen to cook a dish and the very first thing you get is a recipe and you follow the recipe, you work with the recipe, eventually you will master that dish. Same thing applies here. Recipe is nothing but a Toastmasters knowledge. If you apply the recipe of Toastmasters knowledge at home, eventually you will lead a very happy family life. Thank you. Wish you all the best.
Thank you, second speaker from Medley Toastmasters Club. Next up, we have the second speaker from DXC Toastmasters Club coming up, and that is DTM Sriram Venkatraman. So DTM Sriram Venkatraman, floor is all yours.
A small correction, Siddharth. It was already decided that speaker number 2 would be Bala. Yes, I will be the speaker number 3.
All right. Yes. So Toastmaster Balakrishnan. Yes.
Good afternoon, dear guests, Toastmaster and friends. Am I audible? Okay. When we were discussing about who is going to talk in front or in against the topic, Toastmaster Sunil had mentioned that I'm going to argue with the topic. Let me tell you, Toastmaster Sunil or DTM Sunil, that here we are not arguing, we are debating. And debating means putting forward your points in a much more relaxed and logical manner. And the aim is to get the audience and the voters to vote for you without hurting anyone. Whereas arguing is something where there's a heated exchange and mostly the argument is at home, not the debating, and there's always one winner. I don't have to say that who is the winner. We all know that. So coming to this topic, the reason I wanted to talk against the topic is, as you all know, we had a District 82, which now moved into District 120. And out of all these members that we have hardly very few Toastmaster couples. Probably a handful of them. And I managed to get a call from one of them yesterday evening. If you are guessing who is this, yes, that is DTM Sundaraman, sir. He called me yesterday evening and he told me that I asked him very curiously, yes, I'm going to give a debate against this topic tomorrow at your club, but I don't find you either for or against. I don't see him in the audience also, I think. Yeah. So he was just telling, you know, Bala, I mean, we both are Toastmasters and there are certain compulsions. I don't have to state it. I think you are intelligent enough to understand. And I didn't utter a word. I understood that from his Chintan Shivir or Chinta Shivir, he put forward some arguments and that did ring a money in my mind. That was a bell. And I kind of respected that and he told all the best. So that I was very fine about. In all my experiences as Toastmaster, whether as a VP or a president, I try to implement certain rules which came out very handy when I was at the club meetings. I try to implement it during the lockdown. For example, in the 3 months lockdown, I thought, okay, I'll prepare who is going to buy what. Like, I'm going to buy groceries. My wife is going to wash the clothes. And I used to put it in a typical WhatsApp manner that these are the roles assigned. Until now, in the last 3 months, I have seen the tick mark. I have talked, but I have not got an acknowledgement from her. Also, I put a menu where I told Monday it will be dosa in the morning, afternoon it will be rasam sadam, night it will be thai sadam, next day it will be puri, and so on and so on. Till now, I got only upuma. Yes, upuma. Toastmaster Ramesh told that Toastmaster implements the policy of showing appreciation for whatever you do and which he was able to successfully get it in his personal life. I'll tell you, when I gave my first speech, there were many false starts. In those false starts, all the Toastmaster used to say, fail is first attempt in learning. So go on. But when I told the same thing while cooking and it went horribly wrong, I used to say, honey, it is first attempt in learning. She was telling, forget about it, lazy guy. So that's how the perceptions differ. Now I understand why Satya, our own Satya, has not got his wife or family in all the Toastmaster events till now. Previously, till June 30, he had 82 reasons not to get. Now he has, from July 1st, he has 120 reasons not to get. And that, from a seasoned Toastmaster like him, sums up what our predicament is. Coming on a different note, I organized a function for one of my nephew's birthday party. And I thought I'll go it as per the Toastmaster, creating a URL and putting all the posters. And I never got a single response. But on the day of the event, I got so many people attending. And they were well there beyond the time. And as the usual tiredness beyond the time goes in the usual Toastmaster meeting, here I did not find that. They were all very happy. So there was something that you don't have to apply the Toastmaster knowledge always at home. So that was something very important. Finally, to conclude, what I would like to say is, whether you're president of VPA or any other role that you do in Toastmasters, when you come at home, you are just a common person. I keep saying to my wife that we have done President Distinguished, we have done the Star Area Director, all these people are there. And then she says that whether you are a Star Area Director or something, for me, you are just Bala, well without the prefix. Thanks a lot.
So that was the second speaker from DXC Toastmasters Club. And next up, we have DTM Sunil Jose, the third and final speaker from Medley Toastmasters Club. All yours, sir.
Good afternoon, fellow debaters, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear debate master. I fully support the motion. I move to my team member, Toastmaster Vijay Raghavan. Before I start, I would like to tell Toastmaster Balakrishnan one thing. Even before I opened my mouth, you started talking about something which I said. And within this debate, I have not said anything about that. I think completely whatever he said, I completely deny. I have not even aware of whatever I said, but I have not seen. Obviously, all the people who sit here completely knows that I have not opened my mouth. So I don't want to deny on something, counter on something which I did not say. The second thing is about Sundaraman sir, the DTM Sundaraman sir meeting Sundaraman sir yesterday. Again, the factual statements are wrong because Sundaraman sir is not a member of Medley Toastmaster even now. And I completely disagree with him when he say I was so busy because he was taking OTP session. Yesterday, he is part of VP Medley Meraki Toastmaster member of different roles. So completely, maybe he just wanted to take some time off you or wanted to avoid you for something. Maybe he would have said, okay, I'm so busy and I don't have time. The third thing which I want to say, Balakrishnan, is that, you know, your wife, you gave recipes to your wife and your wife did not bring you something else. One thing you should understand, I think you didn't want the point raised by Toastmaster Ramesh. We said giving equal participation to all, giving equal appreciation to all is one thing which you learn from Toastmaster, which you can apply in home. I think this is one reason we would have, you always was distinguishing between Toastmaster and your family life. If you had mixed it, you would have completely, you didn't have this embarrassment situation at home. Now coming to my point, which I respectfully want to counter Toastmaster DTM Gayatri, my good friend, about one thing about time management, how she found out that the time management thing will not work at home. My dear friend, DTM Gayatri, I think you confuse between time management and time consciousness. Toastmaster teaches time consciousness. For example, when I joined Toastmasters, I was a person who was not good at timing. I was late to walk. I was late to my prayers. I was late to my food. Always my wife keep the food. By the time I come, it will become like as if I am taking the food in Iceland. So all the time, then came the Toastmaster into my life, which everything which you do in Toastmaster, we are time conscious, Gayatri. We are time conscious. We are not time managing. So when you are time conscious about something, it automatically comes to your family. You are a human being. It will come to your family. So when you come to the family, when you apply things, your wife calls you for food, immediately what you do, you know about the time. Yeah, the time is very important for me. You go and take it warm food. Okay, you enjoy the food with your family. The second thing is I want to raise a point is about the humor, which you all forgot. We all know we love humor. We love stand-up comedy. Well, we love stand-up comedians. But we know humor is a skill many people have. But have you ever understood that self-deprecating humor is what we make us a better comedian? Or in our contest season, we all try to make self-deprecating humor. And why? Because we want to make others laugh better than my competing, my fellow contestant. My dear friends, if you take it at home, if you, whenever you fight with my wife, my kids, always I have noticed that when it is situation, whenever I try to self-deprecate myself, the situation changed completely. I didn't tell them about what I learned from Toastmasters. The situation changed completely, and I've seen the humor, the self-deprecating humor has become a stress buster in my life, personal life. You cannot distinguish between Toastmaster life and personal life. We are all human. Whatever we learn one place, it is not for our professional life. It is for our family. Also, it is for our personal life. So I am all for the proposition that Toastmaster knowledge is good. A good for a better family and personal life. Over to you.
Thank you, DTM Sunil Jose. Now we have the last and final speaker coming in from DXC, that is DTM Sriram. So DTM Sriram, floor is yours.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Siddharth, and happy Sunday afternoon, dear fellow Toastmasters. Before I start, I am really, really wondering what is the topic is all about. Because our previous speaker, Sunil, the topic was about applying Toastmaster principle. But he was speaking about stand-up comedy. Buzz, you are actually comedy piece in your home. First, you should understand it. You can do only self-deprecating joke. Try a joke with your wife. You know what kind of a food you will take. You might be a lawyer or a liar in a Supreme Court. But to your home, you are just DTM. No DTM, only Sunil. Not even TM will come. Okay. But your first speaker, Toastmaster Vijay Rangan, he started with shouting aggressively, you know, the topic is. And at last, he said, when he was speaking to his wife, he said, honey, can we go for a coffee? That is actually home. Okay. Outside in Toastmaster, you can do high modulation and all modulation. Can you go inside the home and do that? High five. Can we go for a cup of coffee? You are 2 minutes late. Say this to your wife. Never ever life you can see a picture of coffee in your mind. Okay. Then comes Toastmaster Ramesh. The question was, can you include your family members to your Toastmasters? He didn't include, but he said, look at my family members. They are all seeing. Guys, that is what happened. They just saw because what you are speaking. You know, your wife showed this omission. Again, Toastmasters, sir. He's showing our video. Hey, 1 minute. Only that was the action committed by your wife. Not that, oh my great speaker, everything. Asymptotic principles. Only asymptotic is corona only, boss, not any other thing. See, I'll tell you the art of evaluation you learn in Toastmasters, right? For an example, my mom prepared rasam where it did not have salt in it. I told her, since Toastmaster blood runs in my body, I told her, mom, your rasam was awesomeatic. Beautiful tomato pieces and ginger toast. But if you could add little bit of salt to it, I'm sure you will be the awesome chef of 2020. She said, you want only upudan, eh? For that, why you are speaking for 5 minutes? Get lost. This was her response. Okay. So you can't apply all principles at home, man. That's what you need to learn. One day, you know, I got an angry enmity with my neighbor. I took a stone and threw it on your glass window. The window got broken like anything. You know what? My dad came and slapped me 4 times. I was like, ah. Imagine if my father was a Toastmaster, he would have said, Sriram, I know you are an obedient guy, well-matured guy. See, you should not do like this. Next time, try avoiding. If you could please try avoid throwing stones onto other glass window, I am sure you will be the next Abdul Kalam of India. If you would have said that, I would have taken through stones and thrown again and thing. See, all these principles will not work when Toastmasters. I'll tell you why. What is the definition of home? Everybody have forgotten it. There is a difference between a dad and a father. There is always a difference between a house and a Toastmaster. Home means is what, how you are. You need to be original. That is what is called home. Remember, you need a mask only when you go outside the home. Inside, being at the home, you don't need a mask. You need to be as original as you are. Ramesh, I tell you, since your father did not appreciate you, do you actually dislike him? Do you curse him? No, right? You still owe all the things. And if you come to CC10, you will speak only about your dad, right? Take Toastmaster Abraham or Sunil. Why is he here now? All his speeches will be his frustration, what has happened at home. Then only it is called home, man. Okay. Be original at home. Be relaxed. Be whatever you want to do. That is what is home. Application. See, the secret of success is you can follow the principle of your home, but you cannot follow the principles of Toastmasters at your home. Think about it. All the three speakers, please think about it. Next time, when you come inside home, or now you are at inside home, don't follow Toastmasters, because you will end up in being just a Dubakur master only. With this, I hand over the control to the debate master, Siddharth.
Thank you, DTM Sriram. So that brings us to the very end of the debating session per se. Now what we have is the summing up session. So for that, I'd like to call upon Medley's final speaker. That will be DTM Sunil Jose. So sir, stage is all yours.
Yeah, thank you, debate master and my fellow debaters. It was very lovely. And Sriram, I loved your stand-up comedy too much, but I think you missed many points. I think in most of the time you are occupied with the stand-up comedy. So stand-up comedy about all the three debaters from our side. Okay, that's okay. We can understand well, because you took a narrow view of many things happening. It's not straitjacket approach we have to apply to Toastmasters and family. I think you will learn in the course of more learning from Toastmasters. It will inculcate in you a humanitarian or inculcate in you a personal touch to the learnings which you learn in Toastmasters. I believe so and I hope so. Let me conclude now, because it is now proved beyond doubt that it's good to apply Toastmasters knowledge at home. In fact, every skill we learn from Toastmasters have practical application. We already proved with some examples. Due to time constraints, actually, we could point out only a few. Like we said, active listening is what we learned from Toastmasters. Voice modulation helps you, showing appreciation and importance to others, giving importance to others' opinion, and personally effective time consciousness and self-deprecating humor. How all this and many other skills have helped you, then which you could not mention because you all know why you people are here, because you know you are sitting at home. Why your family is permitting you to be at here, you all know the reason. So unfortunately you have to argue against it. Now, Toastmaster, I'm 100% sure you all agree with me, Toastmaster's skills helped to unite, to create more united and happier families. I'm sure the opposite side is fully convinced about it. And it's very good to apply Toastmaster's knowledge. It's not knowledge, not only knowledge, Toastmaster's skills or whatever you traits you learn there, it automatically comes to home. It's not like you learn, you can go home and try to, okay, I will apply this now. No, it's not like that. You are a person, you are a human being. So it comes to you normally. My dear friends, integrity, respect, service, and excellence, the core values of what Toastmasters teaches us. Now, anything we carry home is one of this, for sure. So I'm sure what else you need for a successful family life? You don't need anything. Toastmasters skills are completely good, completely needed, and you apply this in your home. Over to you.
So that was the sum up from Medley Toastmasters side, and now over to DTM Gayatri from DXC for summing up the perspectives of the faction that believes that Toastmasters knowledge cannot be applied at home. Over to you guys.
My dear opponent team, I really appreciate your courage for coming out of home and speaking against. And I'm very sure that you people thought that you proved your point, but we are all aware that we are all living proof that we have to separate Toastmasters from our real life. And we are all living proof. We don't have to prove somebody is alive because they are roaming around, okay? And Sunil, I'm still, at awe, whether you have respect, integrity, or service, or excellence, you can still be part of home only if you have love. House doesn't work on all these principles. It might be a value add, but if a person doesn't have any of this, but still we don't banish them from family, that is what is home. That is not a house is not a corporate company. A Toastmaster is a corporate company, a professional organization where we treat people with a lot of professionalism and dignity, even if we don't like them. But at home, that is not love. If you don't like somebody, you go fight with them, but in the next moment you hug with them and then you live forward, because that is home. We can't apply the Toastmasters principles at home. We have clearly told you, attempting to be very strict with time management at home will only result in people getting hurt. That is not what we want. It's okay for us to start an event late, but we don't want to hurt people around. That is home. If you try to do something in the Toastmaster way, in the very perfect way, involving formal communication, people will not appreciate. You don't actually applaud when your dad gives you a gift. You hug him, you kiss him, or you at least look at him and they realize it. In home, we work on unsaid principles. We don't expect that appreciation or applause because we know that we are there for each other. In summary, I would like to say that we have told you that the Toastmaster principles are all really good, but it is not something that can be applied directly at home, because that will hurt people more than making home a better place. Because at the end of the day, a company cannot run in losses, but a home is fine even if it is broke. What a house should not lose is not respect, integrity, service, excellence, or profit, loss, or club membership, or retention. It is all about being there for each other, accepting people immaterial of what they are, and loving people for eternity. So, my dear Toastmasters, including the opponent team, let me remind you that you may be a district officer, a distinguished Toastmaster, or even a regional advisor or an international director. But end of the day, when you enter your home, enter as a member, not of Toastmasters, but of your family. Because end of the day, they are looking forward for their sons, dads, mothers, sisters, and the person whom loves them, and not the successful leader that you may be outside of the home. Over to the debate master.
Thank you. So we had a wonderful debate, three speakers taking each other on, that is 3+3 taking each other on, and also finally a summary of all that we spoke and discussed for the last half an hour. So now we have the voting link ready. Our Medley VP Toastmaster Raghunath has been very kind to post it a couple of minutes in advance. So he says, vote for the winning debate team and the best debate speaker by clicking the link. We have about a minute's time to go ahead and vote for the speaker that we think aced it all, and also for the team who we think performed exceedingly well overall. We have about a minute's time for this, please. Okay, I see one vote already done. Okay, there's two more done. Perhaps for the others, the Gmail login is taking a little bit of time. We've got nearly a handful of people who voted already, at least as far as the chat is concerned. VP, kindly let us know if we've got all the votes.
We have only 20 votes. I should wait for 30 seconds.
Yeah, please. 30 seconds would be apt. Thank you, sir. VP, could you kindly update, please? Do we have? All right, that's good. So, well, to share my perspective about the debate that we just concluded. Firstly, I'm really glad that we undertook such a kind of an experiment at a time when it is the best for a noon siesta after a heavy Sunday lunch. That's the first thing. And kudos to all of us for having joined. And more importantly, when you say debate, or at least when television journalists think of debate, this is what comes to our mind. Nothing else. Just this. Nothing else. Pure bliss. We had, I think, twice as much as people as Arnab has on his panel. But here's the bright side. We were far more republic than Arnab is to be able to handle this with so much of elan and decorum that we did not have the surround sound that is so typical of Arnab's debates. We didn't have 20 people yelling on top of their voices. We did not have our subwoofers and speakers going crazy, filtering out the noise from actually the content and the news. So, well, at the end of the day, I'd like to just say one thing, that this was a brilliant attempt by two clubs to come together and try a debate. Of course, I'm told that also in the past, Medley had heralded several events where debates had taken place and Medley had done it internally. But if I'm not wrong, this is one of the first ventures to involve another club. And this is unique for the fact that it's not just two community clubs, but different perspectives and different people here, because it's one community club taking on one corporate club. So that is one of the greatest aspects of this debate, and immense gratitude to DTM Thomas Abraham, sir. This gentleman was the one who was at the helm of affairs right from the very beginning. So I believe that we must appreciate him for all the efforts he's put in, and all the participants who've also made time for this, who've spent time to prepare. So when it comes to preparation, I thought I should ask some of you participants, really, did any of you for participating in this debate? I knew all of you were busy, because when I asked you for your introduction, none of you replied. All of you gave the introduction 1 hour prior to the debate. I knew how busy you were. I don't know what you were doing, but I knew you were busy. So I just want to ask you something. How many of you actually tried implementing any of these Toastmasters strategies at home over the last couple of days so that you could use your lessons for the debate? Any of you who tried it?
My evaluation example of Rasam was a tried one, Siddharth. I daily do it. My mom literally reads me the same reply.
Okay, that's one. Anybody else?
Yeah, the real experience that I spoke was actually true. I mean, whatever we experienced, we collated and spoke.
That's phenomenal. Anybody else?
Hey, make everyone feel important. Engaging all the family members. No, even they were part of the script.
Ramesh, debate is over.
They were part of my script writing, actually, the whole family.
Okay, fantastic. Anybody else?
I have to do it, actually. It was part of my, it actually was part of my family life already, Toastmasters. I didn't have to. Even I was talking from the heart, basically.
That's fantastic. Anyway, the votes are in, and also the result is ready. So no faking it anymore. For the sake of perspective. Anybody else? Any other speaker? Anybody else from Medley? Your experience?
Yeah.
Thomas, sir, your experience? Toastmasters' knowledge and experience at home?
You're on mute, sir.
Thomas, sir, you are on mute.
You are on mute, sir.
Oh, both sides wanted to take this topic. That is my final answer, where truth lies, now that the debate is over. Thank you. Let's move on.
As far as I'm concerned, this is what I observed in the debate. And perhaps we could just consider this as an example for further debates as well. This one, perhaps particularly, was something that applies only to married people. Are we in agreement here? So a bulk of the audience, or at least one share of the audience that's single, really does not have an opportunity to talk too much about this. So, which is also why we had the kind of demographic that we had in the participants that we had today. So the six of them were sufficiently married enough for quite a long time to know the pros and cons of married life. Somebody, Sriram, saying he's not married.
Yeah, Sriram is not married.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I said clearly mother man.
Okay, so Sriram's not married. Sriram's not married, all right? So we're discounting him from that particular equation. But anyways, we had about 5 people out of 6 who were married persons. And in fact, when each one of you was speaking, I was pinning your screen, zooming in and looking as much as possible. If there are any little bruises or marks of blue or black after attempting Toastmasters knowledge and implementing it back at home. But luckily, I didn't find any of that on any of your faces. Or I'm not sure if it's very, very high-end HD makeup and graphics technology that's masking all the blacks and blues on your faces, which is the after effect of perhaps implementing Toastmasters knowledge at home. But anyways, we have 34 votes. We had around about 37-40 people who were part of this debate as far as the audience is concerned. And here we are with the results. So the best team is DXC Chennai Toastmasters Club. And the best speaker is a tie, DTM Sriram Venkatraman and DTM Gayatri. And here, there's just one clarification that's just come in. So, I don't know for what reason, maybe because Gayatri is married, sympathy vote, she got a couple of extra votes and Gayatri is now declared clear winner. So this is the sympathy vote you get if you are married and if you have kids and so on. So because Sriram isn't married, he didn't have any mercy. So people did not give him those couple of votes, which gave Gayatri the edge. So now we have a winner here, clear winner, DXC Toastmasters Chennai and also DTM Gayatri. So I'd like to thank everybody for having given me this opportunity, particularly Thomas sir, who's been talking to me for a long time about having debates. And it's his passion that's driving this entire initiative, because all of us can come in the middle and go. We can be the tools that help implement this entire thing and get the show on the road. But I think when you have a nice meal, you've got to thank the chef and not the utensils that made it happen. So thank you, DTM Thomas Abraham, sir, for making this happen. And I'm sure that it'll only be onwards and upwards for all the debates that we're going to have in the community henceforth. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Siddharth, for the elan, for the TV-like style you brought into things, for the energy, for the passion. I'm sure we will have more chefs, not just more food, more chefs and more diners for dinner, for debate in Chennai. We now move on to something that will have a participation of a lot more people. And to lead that, we have a Toastmaster with 4 years with DXC and three already has done 3 terms in the XCOM, including the president. So here is calling for TT, the former president of DXC and currently an automation developer, Swati Das, Toastmaster Swati Das. Over to you, ma'am.
Okay, a small correction, it's Swati Devi, not Swati Das. Welcome to this table topic session. If you want to be a speaker, an influencer who can grab points quickly from your memory bank, organize it and deliver it within a time frame, then I will highly recommend you to be part of a table topic session. Because in this table topic session, as a table topic master, I will be providing you a impromptu topic and place you in a situation where you can practice all this, grabbing your points, organizing it, delivering it within a time limit. And the time limit for table topic session is 1 to 2 minutes. At 1 minute, I will be showing, the timer will be showing the green card, and 1 minute 30 seconds, yellow card will be shown, and at the 2 minute, you will be shown with red card. And after that, you will be having extra 30 seconds of grace time to wind up your speech. So, I hope everyone would have watched the connection game, which was telecasted in Vijay Television. I saw a few of the clubs were trying this as part of a fun activity, and I thought of including that fun activity in table topic session. Today I will be showing you a picture which will have a clue to find a word. And that word will be related to Toastmasters. Toastmaster, public speaking, leadership, only related to these. And you have to find the word. Anyone can guess the word. And after the word is guessed, I will be calling a table topic speaker and give a topic related to that word and ask them to speak. Hope the rule is clear. if anyone have any questions before we jump into the table topic session. Okay, I guess there is no question. Let me quickly share my screen. As I told, anybody can make the guess. Let's have 10 seconds of time for it. So the first one is, you can see my PPT, right? Could anyone confirm that?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, this is the first one. You can start guessing it. Word related to Toastmasters.
Is it presiding officer?
Yes, that's right. Who was that?
This is Snigdha from Toastmasters at Verizon.
Good job. This is a presiding officer, as it was correctly guessed. I will be giving a topic related to this, and let's have Toastmaster, distinguished Toastmaster Partha from DXC Chennai chapter Toastmasters. Do we have Partha online now? Okay, then let me jump to Dinesh Sagar from Medley Toastmasters. Do we have Dinesh?
Yeah. Yes, Madam TT Master.
Yes, sir. Dinesh, your topic is this. What you do has far greater impact than what you say. What you do has far greater impact than what you say.
Thank you, TT Master, for the subject. I completely agree with this. We can say a lot of things, but in practice, we don't implement whatever we say. A very good example of it would be, for example, I always wanted to do my, during this lockdown period, I wanted to do each and every day in a very protective manner, but I have never done it. But perhaps I would say to and advise it to many people also that they also have to use it in a very productive manner. But in the end, people themselves will question me, what have you done? What have you helped in your family so far this lockdown? And so far, and that's the thing that everyone says back. You can give a lot of advice, but in the end, we ourselves won't follow a lot of advice. And also when the advice is given, most people will say, what did you accomplish at all in the first place if you are giving so much of advice? So it's an easy thing to give advice, but it's a very tough thing to follow the advice which has been given. And thank you, and over to our TT Master. Thank you, Madam.
Thank you for that, Dinesh. Shall we jump into the next topic? Next, the clue is from here. Here you go. A word related to Toastmasters.
You haven't shared your screens for
me. Could you see it now?
Yeah.
Word of the day.
Word of the day.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you so much for that enthusiasm you are showing while you guess the answer. So, word of the day. And I would like to call Anand from DXC Chennai Chapter Toastmaster. Do we have Anand? Anand Vishwanathan?
Yes, sure. Yeah.
Anand, your topic is this. Words are free, but its meaning may cost. Words are free, but its meaning may cost.
Thank you, TT Master, for this wonderful topic. I could relate this topic with the debate what we had today. Maybe, see, the words which we offer to anyone, it is the one that they are going to understand, but it is maybe a free of cost, but what we say is more important. If we take a word which you are going to say to your, first of all, to your father, first of all, to your mother, think about what you are going to say. And then if it is going to be a promise, then be careful in what you are going to say. Just by saying words, but if you are not following or not relying on what what has been said, then your personality will be differently taken by the other side. If it is in a family bonding, they may say that he only says that, but he will not follow. He will give only free advices, but it is not followed by others. So that is the reason. See, free of advice can be told by anyone, but relying and following on it, it is a tough at any cost. But if you are following it up, your personality might be at a different level. That is, if you are doing it in your personal life, maybe you might be seen as a different person, as a father, as a mother, or as a personality in your surrounding, you might be seen as a different person. If you are following it in a professional life, then you are seen as a different person. The words are more powerful than if you are telling the words more powerfully, then your personality has been defined. It is not that you are telling it for free, or it is not that if you are telling it for anything out of cost. So you must, everyone here must say that you must be accountable for what you say. That is what I wanted to say. If you are accountable for what you say, I am sure that you will be a different personality all over. Over to Titi Master.
Thank you, Anand, for that, for sharing a lot of profound messages. I now understand that experience is more powerful than words. Let's move on to the next one. Next is this. Can anyone guess it?
TD Master?
No.
Evaluation?
No.
Team of the day?
Come again?
You want to switch? You want to switch?
No.
Appreciation?
Not exactly, no. What is
recognition?
No. What is the first girl showing?
Ribbon. Winning ribbon in a club meeting.
Sergeant at arms.
Ravarian.
No, let me reveal the answer. The answer is communication. So it's communication.
Nice.
To speak on this topic, let's have Dr. Ishwar from Medley Toastmasters. Do we have Dr. Ishwar?
Yes.
Dr. Ishwar, your topic is this. If you can't explain it simply, you don't understand it enough. If you can't explain it simply, you don't understand it enough.
Thank you, PT Master Swati Devi, for giving me this topic. Yeah, I think this is something my advisor will say often. Whenever I explain something in a very complicated manner, he simply says, I didn't understand that. Because for understanding it, understanding something, first you have to explain it in a simple way. Or in other words, if you understand something, then you can explain it in a simple way. And that's where these things also comes up. And even in the Toastmaster, the debate topic is also something in a similar manner, where we have family, we have Toastmasters. Now we have to correlate both of them, and we have to illustrate in a simple way that whether it is applies or whether it doesn't apply. That's where the entire show today has been run up. So if you can understand the logics of the Toastmaster, and if you understand how family runs, then you can easily explain whether it works or not. That's where this the topic given to me also says the same thing. So I agree to this topic. Thank you.
Thank you, Ishwar. So let's move on to the next one. The next clue is this. You can start guessing it. So it's a word related to communication, Toastmaster, public speaking.
Practice makes perfect. Eh?
No. What is the first picture as?
Application.
Okay, application. Then what the next question asks? What do you see in the
Lambani?
Thin.
The fat person then become after practice it becomes thin.
Geo University.
So what is it between after? What
is it? Is it improvement?
No, it's a word related to public speaking. A kind of appreciation.
Applause. Eh?
Yes, that's right. This is the answer. It's an application app and we have lost this weight.
Applause.
So to speak on this topic, let's have Zakir Hussain.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah. Zakir Hussain, your topic is we make excellence by flaws. We make excellence by flaws.
Yeah. Thank you, DT Master. We make excellence by applause. This one applause makes people to give much better out of themselves. Most of the times, the performers or the practitioners and all the same times the actors or the anyone who is doing some job, when we give an applause, when we appreciate them for the work they do, they get really out of the way and do excellent things. By clapping hands and giving a some sort of an appreciation towards them makes them to do much better. It applies to all of us too, particularly in table topics as well as in the meetings of Toastmasters. Many a times I've seen the young budding people get an applause and it gives them to perform much better in the days to come. Always applause has an intrinsic value which gives the people to perform their excellent way. So I always believe whatever the losses, whatever the shortcomings a person, we can overcome by giving an applause. Applause creates a greater energy and instantly make the person to give much better out of him. So I strongly believe whenever you find anyone to give an excellent things, give an applause, appreciate them genuinely and see that that works and make them a miracle will happen within themselves. So applause the magic which lies on our hands. Thank you.
Thank you, Zakir Hussain. I like the way how you told applause genuinely. Let's move on to the next one. Here you have
friendship.
Membership.
Yes, that's right. Membership. So to speak on this topic, let's have Priyadashni from Medley Toastmasters. Priyadashni?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah.
Yes.
So this is your topic. Toastmastering means a lot more than a club membership. Toastmastering means a lot more than a club membership.
Yeah. Very true question. Our debate was on that same subject almost. Now, I would like to put it in this way. Now, there is a pencil. Now, what matters with the pencil is not with what wood the pencil is made of, but it is the lead which shows the quality of the pencil. It may be education or art or anything you learn in life. This is personally, I'm trying to express myself here. Even Toastmastering has been a part of, it's an art for me. So when you try to enhance your skills through learning different forms of art, end of the day, what I get to achieve is the quality of person, how refined this person is going to stand before or stand in front of the society. For me, definitely Toastmastering is not just a club or an activity. I have taken it in a way where I develop myself personally, and it may be at home or in the society. It becomes a part of me. When you make something as a part of you, you don't have to carry it. You know, it comes naturally to you. And definitely a person who has known you for years will see the change might be when you talk or appreciate someone's work. But if you have learned to evaluate in Toastmasters, then you have learned what is the real knack of evaluation. We have definitely learned to see the good more than the negative side of, in the Toastmastering. So carrying that personally, I will say Toastmastering has meant a lot to me. Thank you.
That's me for that profound message. Let's all inculcate Toastmastering rather than adding it or taking it as an add-on along with us. So let's move on with the next topic. The clue is coming now.
Tag players.
Not exactly.
First tag part, team?
Yes, that's right. Tag team. So to speak on this topic, let's have Rogit from Medley Toastmasters. Do we have Rogit?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, Rogit.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, Rogit, I can. Here is your topic, Rogit. Success is working together. Success is working together.
Yeah. Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Sorry. Thank you, Table Topics Master. So, success is working together. Yes, I truly believe. I also believe that success can come even with working together or even working individually as well. But if you look at it, when you work together, when you work with a set of people, when you put in your thoughts, when people with different traits and different characters and different skills come together, there is a combination of different skills that can add more energy, and the output becomes a lot more better and it becomes a lot more efficient. So definitely when there are multiple hands, multiple minds and multiple skill sets put together to produce something, to see that the final objective is met, of course it means it does make a lot of difference when there are multiple hands involved. But you can also say that success can happen individually also, where there are people who work on a silo, when they don't have too many people coming together, and if there is a skill that needs to be, if there is something that needs to be done with a specific skill, and there's only one person who has multiple skills, who thinks that he can, if he has the ability to achieve or produce something on his own or her own, nothing like it. So, success can be either individually or with in a group. So ultimately what matters is the final output and if the final objective is met. So I think this is my take on your topic. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Table Topic Master.
Thank you so much, Rohit. Let's move on to the next topic. On screen now.
Looks like ribbon, but I'm not sure.
Yes, that's right. It's ribbon. So, to speak on this topic, do we have a distinguished Toastmaster Partha? Do we have Bala Jyoti from DXC? Balajyoti. Okay. Do we have Murugaswamy? Murugaswamy from DXT.
Yes, Swari.
Yeah. Murugaswamy, the topic is this ribbon or opportunities. Ribbon for opportunities.
Thank you, Swadi. Yeah.
wherever we are going to work, okay, there should be some challenge. So if you achieve challenge, so everyone will encourage. So by cutting the ribbon, so everyone encourage cutting the ribbon, it won't will get into the next level. Okay, so if you go to next level, so step by step, if you go to the next level, so everywhere will be getting the opportunity. Okay, that the ribbon is nothing but is motivate each and every level to achieve our goals. So but if you go anywhere, if you see any other club ribbon, so we will think, okay, we have to achieve something to get that ribbon, so it will be visible to everyone. So such a way that so we will plan accordingly wherever we go. Okay, and even if you watch any football match or tennis, suppose they are getting some medal or something, so in mind we will think, okay, so why can't we try to get the ribbon? So we can try to practice in that way. So at least, okay, we will get some idea the ribbon. Okay, so wherever we get the opportunity, we can use and we can achieve to get the ribbon. Yeah, thank you. Over to you, Kitty.
Prakaswami, reiterating that we should be open to opportunity. You can start guessing it. A word related to Toastmaster. And this is especially used 90% of the times in Toastmaster. Hello.
Appreciation.
Not exactly. You see the letter RA, right? That will be part of the word itself. And this is a
contribution.
Is it?
No.
Is it return on investment?
Is it grammarian?
Yes, that's grammarian, right. Grammarian. Yes. To speak on this, let's have Periyannaswamy from Medley Toastmasters. Or Periyaswamy, sorry. Periyaswamy? Okay. Sampath? Nityam Sampath? Do we have distinguished Toastmaster Sampath in the call? We have Surya?
Yes, I'm there.
Yeah, Surya. Your topic is this. Bad grammar can cost you a lot. Bad grammar can cost you a lot.
Okay. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Bad grammar can cost you a lot. I strongly believe this statement because that is one of the reasons why I joined the Toastmasters. Not only improving my public speaking, but also when it comes to written English, writing. Because my particular job that I'm doing depends a lot in writing, conveying the message. I work as a HR in an organization, as a HR BP. So even every single word that I speak has to be communicated in English in this current scenario for the company that I work for, especially. So even if I utter a small minor error in the grammar while I speak or even when I write, that leads to a huge problem. No, it won't. The small mistake that I do won't tell us Surya had made a mistake. It would say HR had made a mistake. So everything will be seen in a big picture by every single people who points out our mistakes. So that is very important when it comes to English, especially. So that's what I would like to conclude my speech. Thank you.
Toastmaster Surya, you will explain that it will cost a lot, not just for you, but for the entire HR department and even for the organization. Well, thank you so much, Surya. Timer, could you please tell me how many more table topic speakers I can have?
Toastmaster Dinesh?
No. How many more speakers? Based on the timings, we have allotted 30 of time.
Another two you can.
Okay, thank you, Thomas. For the next topic, I would like to call Venkateshan. Do we have Venkateshan on the call?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, Venkateshan, this is your topic. you get what you work for, not what you wish for. You get what you work for, not what you wish for.
Yes, thank you for the nice topic. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guest DXA Toastmaster Club also. You get what you work for, not what you wish for. But the time will take for success and other things. If you work very hard in your project, it should be recognized by your client as well as by your office management and HR management. Then only your success will be considered. Initially, I'm not looking for anything else. I would like to work to the core on behalf of, in favor of my company. Then later, the success creeps on. Like when I joined as a programmer executive, then I have developed even in the legal sections and I got promotions and I got very good appraisals for the 2 years before. Because first you should focus on your work and later the achievement, and you should keep on trying for the achievement. You are not supposed to expect anything, either monetary or material benefits from the company. Or once it arises, reaches on the top your level, your job professional level, automatically the company will appreciate you. Thank you for the nice topic, table topic, Master.
Yeah, thank you, Vengatesh. Last speaker, do we have Shruti in the call? Shruti, are you here in the call? Do we have Ram Prasad? Ram. Pavitra? Pavitra Sridhar?
Hi, Swati.
Yeah, Pavitra, here is your topic. Big problems have simple solutions. Big problems have simple solutions.
Thanks for the topic, Swati. This is something that is very, very relatable to me. We all, when a problem is given to us, we all see it to be pretty big when it's in front of us. But when we try and break it down, it is something very, very small and simple, which is a solution to a problem. So I can take one example from my life. When I tried baking during the lockdown, right, I failed almost 4 or 5 times in baking a cake. Every time the cake used to either get, burnt out, or the cake used to overflow. I realized that the simple problem. So I used to make cooker cakes. So I realized that the simple solution to this particular problem was mainly to remove the whistle from the cooker and also to remove the gasket. So that was a very, very simple solution to the problem, but I tried various different things of, maybe my ingredients are wrong, maybe the way I'm doing it is wrong. I changed the vessel, I changed the quantities, etc. But I realized it was a very, very simple, solution that I went and asked someone who was very, very experienced in baking and, found an answer to it. So this is something that I think I can relate to even in bigger problems in life. Be it at work or at home, be very, very small that we don't think of. But if we try and break it down, we can figure out that it's a very, very, very simple thing. Thank you, and over to you, Swati.
Yeah, thank you, Pavitra. Whenever we try to fix something, the problem must be very simple. Basically, lies on the identifying the problem and solving it. Thank you so much for all the table topic speakers. Over to presiding officer. Before that, I would like to have the qualified table topic speakers list. The timer, could you please list the qualified table topic speaker?
Yeah, sure. Table topic master, Toastmaster Dinesh, Toastmaster Anand, Toastmaster Zakir Hussain, Toastmaster Priya, Toastmaster Rogit, Toastmaster Murugaswamy, Toastmaster Surya, Toastmaster Venkateshan, Toastmaster Pavitra Sridhar.
Yeah, thank you, timer. Over to the president.
Thank you, Table Topic Master Swati. So it was really nice to see some clues before the topic, and then people were guessing. So it was really nice. And kudos to all the table topic speakers. Everyone attempted well. And I would like to thank all the debaters and the moderator, Toastmaster Siddharth. And it was a really nice session. And I want to thank distinguished Toastmaster Thomas for initiating the idea of having this debate. It's time that we get the feedback about the meeting. Can I request distinguished Toastmaster Sauri Rajan to provide the feedback? Okay, so do we have C3 Area Director Toastmaster Ram Prasad in the call?
I'm afraid not.
Okay. Let's see. Do we have C1 Area Director Toastmaster Nadira? All right. So let's get feedback from the guests then. Do we have Toastmaster Jagadishan from Coimbatore Toastmasters? Okay, do we have Toastmaster Bharadwaj from Bangalore? Okay. Okay, so anyone want to share the feedback about the meeting? Someone who did not attempt the table topic, or if someone wants to convey something.
It was a very, very interesting table topic session by Swati. I think it was a very, very innovative way of doing it. I could see a lot of enthusiasm from the crowd to, you know, figure out the answers. I think that was really, really well done. And the debate as well was pretty, it was a heated argument, like how Siddharth said, but in a very, 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 very diplomatic and in a very, very, way in which they put the arguments was very, very good. So I think overall a very informative session.
Yep. Thank you, Toastmaster Pavitra, for sharing your feedback. So do we have any business announcements to be discussed? Okay, if not, I am formally adjourning this meeting, and thank you everyone for your presence. It was a very well done meeting. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well done. And a sense of timing, I must appreciate. We managed to finish it up on time.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And sorry, Swati, where do you manufacture these cues? This visual clues, where do you manufacture these? The visual clues.
I saw this thing happening in some of the clubs. Yesterday, I was just sitting and writing the words related to Toastmaster and finding it, the picture in the Google, and I managed to prepare the PPT.
Right.
Yeah.
So, our next agenda is to get Sriram married. Okay, so thank
like lockdown wedding with like less than 50 people, or like your grand big fat Indian wedding in 10 years from now?
We'll have a separate debate on that, Siddharth, and you'll be the moderator on the same.
There also.
Yeah. Where did you get the, who gave you this rumor?
But will he be married by then? He should have enough experience to judge it, no? Will he be married by then?
Who, me?
Make it conditional.
Yeah. Okay, then I think it's better that Sriram finds somebody else.
Find somebody else, okay.
Siddharth, you get brownie points if you get married.
No, it's okay. The only thing you get is sympathy vote and you'll win the best speaker.
Just to win this election, I don't want to get married, right?
That I'll get it via merit. I don't need management quota seat.
Just to win this debate, I don't want to get married. So it's Gayatri. Take that sympathy. Sabhapati, homeopathy, all works for you.
With permission, may I carry on? I got a district council meeting.
So the best tabletop speaker is Priyadarshini. I think we need to congratulate her.
Congrats. That's absolutely. Yeah. The team and the winners. Congrats. Very well done.
Yeah. Congrats to you.
You'll have more of it. Okay. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for organizing it. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone. Bye.
Thank
nice
you.
To
catch
Bye-bye. Up. Bye, everyone. Sunil, we are expecting your next humorous speech. Gone.
Sunil went.
He was pinging me. Eh? Stand-up comedy was pinging me. So, Kumaravel, happy?
Yes, dude.
Kumaravel was like, ayyo, these kind of speakers, you will not have to do
anything. Okay, see you all later. We'll connect later.
Bye-bye.
Yeah.
Bye. Thank you, Partha.
என்ன ஸ்ரீராம் சொல்லுங்க.